looking at a beautiful young lady who, when I grow up, I want to be just like her, Susan Elaine. Susan Elaine, I think we should show them what you're going to do first. So here we go.
Thank you.
Oh, boy, went back to Napoli because he missed the scenery, native dancers and the charming songs. But wait a minute. Something's wrong. Hey, 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 Alice, hey, Mambo, Mambo Italiano, hey, Mambo, hey, Mambo Italiano, go, go, Joe, you mixed up Siciliano, are you calibrated to the Mambo like a hey, hey, Mambo, don't want to tell it all, hey, Mambo, no more. Take her, baby, shake her, cause I love her when you take her in. Hey, Jadroom, you're gonna have to go to school. Just make a little beat, Bombino, it's like the Dino. Cause you're good looking, but you don't know what to do. Baby shaker, cause I love her when you take her. You buy the pizzeria, that's the way it's gonna be. Don't you tell her mama, mama's gonna tell her papa. There's nothing to it, come on baby, let's all do it. Oh, hey Mambo, Mambo Italiano. Hey Mambo Italiano. Go, 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 shake it like a Giovanni. This is so delicia, everybody gonna go fish your heart to it. Mambo Italiano.
Yes! Woo! Yes! Definitely want to grow up to be like her.
She's a mama.
Sit down, sweet thing. So, Susan Elaine, you began, you were a young lady. How old were you when you started singing?
I didn't really start really singing until I was about 46 or 47.
Really? I love that. See, it's never over. Hello?
It's so true, and you're such an inspiration to that because, you
I
know,
think that's fabulous.
Yes, it's something that I always wanted to do, but right. You know, life, and, you know, I didn't have the ways and means of having the classes and things that, correct, you know, when I wanted when I was
right.
young. But I just kind of always, it was in the back of my mind.
Well, you used to mimic some of the stars.
Yes, yeah. Yes.
Like who? Like who did you?
Oh, well, I was the one that was in front of the TV watching Shirley Temple and trying to mimic her and, you know, Judy Garland. I just loved, you know, watching all of that. And my mother was singing in the kitchen.
Oh, really? Okay.
You know, so it was always a part of us, but just
to
never
get out
had
there.
The
right.
opportunity to do anything.
I think that
it.
Is fabulous. And then you took dancing lessons,
mm-hmm,
acting.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, have you been doing that at all?
I would just, again, I would just take whatever I could
right.
along the way while I was trying to struggle and just get through life. And then as I got older, you know, I had a little fun with, you know, I was actually singing Wench in the Renaissance Fair and would do things like that. But then I took a real career move, and I actually was a real estate appraiser for a while.
Oh, wow.
And then...
Now, wait, we know Knott's Berry Farm, though.
Yes,
tell
yes.
us what we did there.
Yes, I went back to, after that, I had my son at 40, and my first and only child at 40. And then I raised him while I was raising him as a stay-at-home mom, and I started working on the creative side again.
Great.
So I started doing murals for friends and neighbors and custom cakes.
Oh,
and things
so
like
you're
that.
An artist. Okay.
Artist. And then when he was old enough for me to start getting back into work again,
right.
I said, I'm going to stay with the creative side. And that's when I was hired by Knott's Berry Farm as a scenic artist.
Wow.
And I love painting the scenes, but I really want to be on the stages.
Well, I want to hear one more song at least. And I know our audience out there does. So would you give me the honor of another song?
I would love to. Thank you.
Baby, why don't we paint the town? And all that jazz, I'm gonna rouge my knees and roll my stockings down. And all that jazz. Start the car, I know a whoopee spot where the gin is cold, but the piano's hot. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl. And all that lick your hair and wear your buckle shoes. And all that jazz, I hear the bottle dip is gonna blow the blues. And all that jazz, hold on, hon, we're gonna bunny hug. I bought some aspirin down at United Drug in case we shake apart and want a brand new start to do that.
Susan, you are adorable. You know, I seldom say this. I mean, I say it all the time. But that's what I mean when I say to people that it ain't over until you out there, until you say it's over. Then it's over. But until that time, why not go for it? It doesn't matter whether you're 20, 40, 50,
right.
80.
Right.
Who cares? If you know what you feel that you want to do, if you've got the chutzpah, the gall, the pizzazz to get out there and want to do something, go for it. It's your life. It's not your neighbor's life or your kid's life. It's your life. Don't give it up.
We had a lady sitting in that very chair recently who was 85, had just come back from Nepal, where she climbed Mount Everest.
Oh, at 85 years young.
And on an earlier program, we had someone who was about to be 96.
96.
Who was having a concert the following weekend.
I saw that.
I know.
Amazing.
So,
you know,
I mean, what I say to people is when they look at me and they'll go, Pink, what are you doing? You're going to be 86. I said, excuse me. Say I'm only going to be 86 years young because it's your spirit. And it's how, I always say, it's your attitude, number one. Number two, it's the gratitude, thank you, God, for giving me the energy to feel the way I do.
Yes.
And you are a delight. I thank you. What are your plans for coming up? Anything special?
Yes, the dreams are never over. They're starting, right? So I had a lot of fun working in a lot of assisted living. My mother's an Alzheimer's patient, so that's near to my heart. So doing more of that.
And they love it. They love music.
I love performing and watching the memories come back, and they just remember those songs. They might not remember who they are,
that's
but they know the songs.
You are so right.
And I like that. I'd like to do more of that. I would someday, I'm always using my own accompaniment, my CDs, but be accompanied. But my highest goal would be to perform with an orchestra someday. That'd be wonderful.
Well, you
and
know
it's
what?
Still out there. It's 60 years old, I think I can do it.
How young 60. Are you? 60, a child, my friends. Thank you, Susan Elaine.
You
blessed us today with a lovely personality, a great voice, and I am so lucky to know you, and I thank you again. Everyone, Pink Lady presents a show for you of lives well lived. God bless all of you. See you next week.
See you next time, folks.
Thank you. You're an inspiration.
You're listening to Pink Lady Presents, only on LA Talk Radio.